If I don't wake up
early in the morning,
if I don't wake up,
broadcasting from the First National Bank Tower, this is KLEKLP Jonesboro, the voice of Arkansas Minority Advocacy Council.
Good Wednesday morning, Jonesboro. This is meteorologist Tim Root with your KLEK 102.5 forecast. Clouds are lower and thickened today, the high around 52, 53, light southwest winds. A brand new storm forming over Texas that'll be giving us rain showers later tonight, mostly cloudy in the mid-40s. Good chance of rain showers Thursday and Thursday night, mostly cloudy skies in the mid-50s Thursday. And it looks like Friday, more rain showers in the low 50s. Your life, your music, we're KLEK 102.5 FM.
From Feature Story News in London, I'm Ollie Barrett. UK Prime Minister Theresa May's own MPs will vote later on whether to remove her as leader of the Conservative Party. French police are hunting the shooter who killed several people in an attack on a Christmas market in Strasbourg. Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi's BJP has lost to the country's main opposition party, the Congress, in three crucial state elections. And US President Donald Trump says he might intervene in the case of Huawei exec Meng Wanzhou.
Matthew 6 and 14. For if you forgive other people when they sin against you, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. God has forgiven our sins because of his undying love for us. Thankfully, he doesn't hold grudges against us. Thankfully, we're told in Micah when we repent, he casts our sins into the sea. Thankfully, he wants to forgive us as opposed to wanting to condemn us. So here's our quiz. Do you hold grudges against others? Do you move on and let go when people seek your forgiveness? Do you want to forgive people, or do you look for the worst in everyone? If you answer any of these questions in the affirmative, you have work to do. I suspect if any of you are like me, we have work to do. God forgives us and expects us to forgive each other, period. There is nothing we can do that will make God stop loving us. These are tough questions requiring honest answers. Pray on it. I pray you have an awesome opportunity to worship in Christ today. May God bless you all. Amen.
It's 8:02.
KLEK 102.5 FM. Good morning to you on your Wednesday. It's December 12, 2018. This is your Wednesday morning Bible study. Care to Wonder is in the studio with you. I am joined by Elder Glen Conley, pastor of Miller's Temple Church of God in Christ. And he is filling in for Reverend Ota. Reverend Ota is going to be out for the next 3 weeks. He is going home to his native country of Nigeria to meditate, to fast, and to pray. So we definitely pray that Reverend Ota returns safely at the end of this year. But we do have Elder Conley here, and Elder Conley is going to talk to us today on being created in his image. So let's go ahead and get into it. This is your Wednesday morning Bible study on KLEK 102.5 FM.
Good morning. Good morning to my brothers and sisters. What a joy and a privilege to be able to come to you this morning. We certainly are lifting up Dr. Ota and his efforts and what he's doing there and his hometown there, just seeking God for revelation and how to go move forward in this 2019 brand new year's coming up. I just want to share a few words with you on this morning about image. It's so very important as we, as not only as people and individual, understand how we were created and what we were created for, and what is our assignment in this earth. And one of the things that I looked at was in this little short series is help us to understand, to renew our mind, to realize that we were not created like any other animal or any other being that God made. For the Bible says that when he got ready to make man, he said, let us make man in our image. As a matter of fact, if you look in Genesis chapter 1, verses 26 to 28, it says, then God said, let us make man in our image, according to our likeness. Let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowls of the air, over the cattle, and over all and over all the things of the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth on the earth. So God created man in his image and in his likeness, in his image, his own image, I'm sorry, and in the image of God create he them. Then God blessed them and called, and God said to them, be fruitful and multiply and fill the earth and subdue it, and have dominion over it, or the fish of the sea, or the birds of the air, or every living creature that moves on the earth. Notice when God says image, the word image says what? It talks about imitation. It means, the Webster Dictionary says this, an imitation or representation of a person. The visual impression of something produced by reflection from a mirror. Ooh, that's good right there. In other words, when God wanted to make a man, he looked at himself. And when he looked at himself, he simply copied himself in such a form, praise God, that one preacher said when the angels looked at man, they thought they were seeing double because they were seeing God. And so it's very important for us to grab hold of that, because people will try to give you an image or make you like to be somebody else. I find out that there's only one. God created each of us uniquely. The Bible said we are fearfully and wonderfully made. In other words, we're unique. We're unique. We're created in his image, like him, in every aspect. Notice what he did. He said, in our image and according to our likeness. Well, he gave them this image so that they can understand that they're not just any creature, but they're gods. That we're God. We're like gods. As a matter of fact, we were gods on this, God's represented. We are God's represented on this earth. And so God created us to be like him and to walk like him and be like him and to operate like him, so that we will be like no other creature. And we have this special relationship that no other creature or being has, and that is to be one with him. But man failed. And when man failed, it marred his image. And now, instead of us seeing us ourselves as God sees us, now we see ourselves as the enemy has portrayed us, that we're weak, we're defeated, we're lack, we're insufficient, we have low self-esteem, and then we feel like we never can meet up to other people's expectations. But then God sends his son Jesus. And when he sent his son Jesus, what did he do? The Bible says that he died for our sin. He came to redeem man back to God, to give them the right perspective and the right image as to who we are, whose we are, and what our assignment is in this earth. Oh, saints of God, people of God, it is so much great and so awesome for us to know that we're created in his image. So God sent his son Jesus to restore that mindset, that perception, that viewpoint, so that we would not try to be like anybody else, but we would try to be like him. Father, look at what it says in the scriptures of Ephesians chapter 2, in verse number 8, I like this. It says, for by grace have you been saved through faith, that not of yourself, it is a gift of God, not of works, lest any man shall boast, for we are his, watch this, his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God has prepared beforehand that we should walk in them. Oh, look at that, my brothers and sisters. In other words, it says God was grace. Grace, what is grace? God's mercy extended to us that which we didn't deserve. But grace is all not only mercy, but it's his love that says that even though you don't deserve it, I give it to you because I love you. Praise God. I love you not because of what you did. I love you because of who I am and because I created you in my image, and I want to restore you back. It's almost like that prodigal son. The Bible says that, that tells us about that when the prodigal son got to an age, he asked his father for his inheritance. He gave it to him, and he went out, and he spent it in righteous living. And when he did all of that, then the Bible says after he had spent all his savings of money and everything that he had, the Bible said he became hungry. and he began to put himself in a position to be feeding hogs. And then the Bible says the son came to himself. The Bible said, and he came to him himself. He said, "How much?" He said, "You know what?" Paraphrasing it, he said, "Look, my father, I could do better than this. I'm better than this, so I'm going back home to my father. But I'm not going with the attitude that I'm his son anymore. I'm going to attitude with servant. My father's servants live better than this." Praise God. But the Bible says that when the father saw the son far off, the Bible said he went and ran after the son. Praise God, and embraced him. Praise God. And when he embraced him, praise God, probably was smelling, you know, around the hog. Praise God. It probably was smelling bad. He was looking bad. But instead of that, his father didn't care how he looked, what he had on, amen, and how he walked or talked. That was his son, and he embraced him, and he says to the servants, he said, "Hey man, bring him the best robe, amen. Clean him up." And he said, "Father, I can't sit at the table with you." He said, "No, son." He said, "You don't realize you were once dead, but now you're alive." Yeah. So that's why the Bible tells us about if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Praise God, a new creation. Recreated, amen, in Christ Jesus. Now, guess what happened? Now we become the righteousness of God through the finished work of Christ Jesus. And that's what the amen, the prodigal son didn't realize. But the prodigal son, the father began to tell him about it. He said, "Son, no. You are always my son. You've been my son. You may have went away from me, but you're still my son, and I love you, and I want to restore you back, amen, to your rightful position and to your rightful place. No, you are no longer a servant, but you are a son." Praise God. And he wanted him to have that sonship attitude and that sonship mindset. And that's what God wants us to do, to have that sonship mindset, to understand that, do you not know that we are God's sons? The Bible said, as to many as received Jesus, to him he gave power or the privilege to become sons of God. Wow, I'm no longer a servant, but a son. And now I have the privilege of sonship. Praise God. Isn't that wonderful? And what is that privilege? Everything, the Bible said, everything that Christ has, amen, guess what? We're joint heirs with him. Wow. Amen. Everything that he has, we got it. Praise God. That's the attitude. That's the mindset. That's the perception that God wants us to have is, amen, praise God. Not look on the outside, but look in the inside. Look into his word. Look into what, into the mirror. Notice what he says. Notice what a definition of the word image. The visual impression of something produced by reflection from a mirror. So when we look into the mirror, what is a mirror, sir? The word of God. When we look into the word of God, it's a mirror to give us our true identity. It's a mirror to show us who we really are. All the world want to tell us, or people will tell us, "Well, you too short, you too small, you too fat, you too this, you too that," and we try to live up to the image of what somebody else has said we ought to be. No, if you want your true image, you got to look in the mirror. And what is the mirror? The Word of God. The Word of God is our mirror to help us to to see who we really are. The Bible says that man looks on the outer appearance, but God looks into the heart. Isn't that wonderful? God is only looks into the heart. It's inwardly. It's inward. What's inward? The Bible says that we're created in his image and his likeness. So as we're created in the inwardly, then what God wants us to do is work out. I like that, to work it out. What's in me, work it out. What's in me? Christ in me, the hope of glory. What's in me? Amen. The Holy Spirit. He's dwelling with me and in me. Praise God. What's in me? The Father. So I have the Father. I have the image of the Father. I have the image of the Father through the Son, Jesus Christ, and then it is expressed through me by the Holy Spirit. Ooh, that's good. Praise God. So that's what, and when I see who I am and whose I am, then I can lift my head up. Then I can walk with a sense of boldness and confidence as to know that I'm God's child. And I know this, as God's child, whatever I have need of, He knows I have need of it already. All I have to do is ask. Praise God. Ask and it shall be given. Seek and ye shall find. Knock and the door shall be opened. When sickness try to attack my body, what shall I do? I resist that sickness because God's word says that Jesus Christ, amen, bore my sicknesses and carried all of my diseases, and with His stripes, I am healed. Praise God. Not that I'm going to be healed, but I'm already done. Praise God. It's a finished work. So I've got to keep that in mind. Praise God. As I walk this daily walk, that God loves me. And when He looks at me, He just doesn't see me, but He sees His Son in me. And boy, he said, "This is my beloved Son, whom I'm well pleased." My brothers and sisters, I pray that you would, amen, keep the word, the Bible says, in front of you. The Bible says, this book of the law, He tells Joshua, this book of the law shall not depart out of your mouth, but you shall meditate on it how? Day and night, so that you may observe to do everything that's written therein, and then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and thou shalt have good success. But another scripture, Jesus comes along, and St. John says this, if you continue in my word, you will know the truth. And the truth, watch this, will make you free. Praise God. When you know who you are and know whose you are, praise God. The Bible said nothing will be able to separate you from the love. No, nothing you face, amen, in your life today, amen, you will not be able to overcome, because God has already given us the victory. Praise God. So when I wake up in the morning, you know what I say? This is the day that the Lord has made, and we shall rejoice and be glad. You know why I'm glad for today? Because my daddy made the day. Praise God. And if my daddy made the day, I know my daddy has knew what I had need of, and He's already provided everything that I have need of today. So my brothers and sisters, I just wanted to share that with you this morning about image. Amen. Don't allow the world, amen, to paint an image of you. Praise God. Get in the mirror. Get in the Word of God and see what the Word of God says about you. And when you see what the Word says about you in every situation, the Word of God must be the final authority in every matter of our lives. And when we put that Word of God there as the final authority in every area of our life, you know what we will do? We would say, no matter what circumstances may bring against us or come against us or what we face, you know what we'll say? Hey, I'm looking in the mirror, and the mirror says to me, I am God's child. The mirror says to me, I am the righteousness of God through Christ Jesus. I am, amen, a child of God. I am heir of God and joint heirs with Jesus Christ. I'm more than a conqueror through Him that loved me. Praise God. And guess what? Anything I face, praise God, God knew that I would face it, knew that I would face it. And guess what? He's already given me the victory for it. You know what I got to do? I just got to walk in the image. Praise God. Isn't that awesome?
Yes, sir. Amen. And definitely thank you, Elder Conley, for that Bible study. And, of course, if you want to walk in the image of Christ, then all you have to do is to just repeat this prayer after me, and you can be saved. Lord Jesus, I come to you today as a sinner.
I come to you today as a sinner.
Forgive me my sins.
Forgive me of my sins.
Wash me with your blood.
Wash me with your blood.
Make me a child of God.
Make me a child of God.
I believe you died for me.
I believe you died for me.
And on the third day you rose again.
On the third day you rose again.
That I might be justified.
That I may be justified.
Thank you, Jesus, for saving me.
Thank you, Jesus, for saving me.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. If you have prayed that prayer, congratulations. You are now saved. Find a Bible teaching and Bible believing church and fellowship with a body of believers. Elder Conley, tell them where your church is at and about your worship opportunities.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. We're at 524 North Church Street, Mellows Temple Church of God in Christ. And our services on Sunday at 10 o'clock, On Sunday night, we have 1 hour of power from 7 to 8. On Tuesday night, we have TNT. Amen. Pastoral teaching on Tuesday night at 7 o'clock. And actually, this morning, we have Morning Manor at 10 o'clock.
All right. And that's prayer, right?
Morning Manor?
Mm-hmm.
No. That's actually a Bible study.
Okay. It's a Bible study. All right,
yes,
so,
sir.
So if you enjoyed what you heard on the radio, you can go to Miller's Temple and get more at 10 a.m. for the Morning Manor. Go ahead and get into our Facebook shout-outs, and then I'll ask for Elder Conley to close us in prayer. Shout-out to Reverend Ota, who is watching all the way in Nigeria. Adrian Everett, Brad Dillon, Gretchen Hyatt, Dr. Kimberly Davis, Dr. Lisa Williams, Tashonda Whitfield, Bishop Adrian Rogers, T. Lynn Valencia, Leslie Vishante, and Billy Hill. So appreciate each and every one of you for checking in on our Wednesday morning Bible study. Feel free to share this video. Now, Elder Conley, if you can close us in prayer, and also extend a special prayer to our own Brother Cobb. So yesterday we had our escape party, and Brother Cobb sustained the fall, and he was knocked unconscious and sustained some injuries, and he's currently being checked out at St. Bernard's. He will not be in for All Gospel Wednesday today. The music's still going to play, but he won't be here. But definitely want to lift him up in prayer and just close us out in prayer.
Yes, sir. Father, we thank you for today. And Father, we lift up our brother, amen, Brother Cobb, today in Jesus' name. As we have said before, we look in the mirror. The mirror is the Word of God. And the Word of God says, Himself bore our sicknesses and carried all of our diseases. And with your stripes, we were healed. So, Father, today, in Jesus' name, we thank you for our minister, God. We thank you for him today, God, that he is healed. Amen. Praise God. The doctor's report, amen, will be reversed. We believe that the bleeding will stop. We plead the blood of Jesus. Amen. Praise God. And that all is well. And he walk in divine health, wealth, and wisdom. And we'll bless you for it. In Jesus' name. Thank you, Father, for this opportunity. And may this day be the best day of our lives. In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. And thank you, Elder Conley, for joining us on this Bible study. I'm sure Reverend Ota will gladly have you fill in for him again.
Bless you, sir.
And we'll be back next Wednesday. I believe Dr. Flanagan is going to be filling in next week on the Bible study. Of course, All Gospel Wednesday will continue all day long. And coming up at the top of the hour, Kubila will be here with Community Conversations. You guys have a great and blessed day. This is Kate, L.E.K. on the 2.5 FM.
This is Dr. Sharice.